problems when you look at the human body, you need this. Not this. Not this. Not this as I saw in the cupboard, son. On to boyfriend. The rings, what the hell are these? Oh, and then we make them really fun for the kids. We stick one on each finger. Oh, that is just, you know. And these add, you know, look at these. They make these biscuits into, oh, now they become a lolly, little treat packs. It won't be long before JC Quality Foods, you will see my face there. So we are now doing a range of foods that will be ready to be able to do the fundraising in. And it's really cheap at birthday parties when you give out this stuff because half the kids leave it. So you get to keep it. It's not really expensive. Knock yourself out. Here's another way. What about we sold the school's dehydrators, or dehydrators were sold to the parents as a fundraiser for the school? Well, we look at this, and I happen to see on someone's table, and I won't look at anyone. But they happen to be there, and I bet you if I went through bags, we'll find more of these. These are the worst thing,
not in mine,
you could possibly have. When I worked in neurology, MS, motor neuron, all the things, pins and needles, numbness in the human body is from what is in here. You would be better off with the sugar. Not that I'm saying that. Did you know if you soak dates in water and puree them, you've got a sweet paste, which can be used for a whole lot of other things. Throw them out, girl. Don't have them again. Or you'll have someone wiping your ass for you because you will have forgotten. This is the first sign of problems in the nervous system. Now, didn't I say at the beginning, 1 in 9 out of kids up to age 14 are contemplating suicide? You know? Might their brain be messed up? And what do they tell you? Suck on mints, fresh breath, all that sort of thing? Well, let me tell you something.
What? No, I'm just saying it's sugar-free, but then it's not, is
it? It is. It's got aspartame in it. If I said this has got potassium, magnesium, boron, silica, all that sort of thing, you're going, yeah, good enough. And yet people go, common sense. Let me just talk about weight loss for a minute. Why we are resistant, because obesity is relevant in our schools. We are fat because of the fact, two things. I'm just going to touch on one which I have, and then I'm going to go back to the main one. One is a microwave. It radiates a thyroid gland, so your metabolism is messed up. I've never seen a case of gastrointestinal cancer. There's a sphincter at the top of the gut here, which opens and closes when we swallow. What happens is that gets radiated, it doesn't shut properly, so we have reflux. Do you know the largest selling supplement in the world, apart from laxatives, is antacids? Antacids means we can't break it down, laxatives means we can't get the shit out. We can't break it down, we can't get it out. Isn't it funny that they are the largest selling supplement? Let me tell you about weight loss. So what happens with weight loss is we use the model, we'll go low carb, okay? Our body needs carbs, it needs sugars as fuel. So we go low carb, not really working, because when you don't have the sugars in the diet, the body goes, oh, I'm going to have a sugar fix and I'm going to have it, especially if you've already had this for. Where are you going? Make a little point, sit down. So if you go, okay, low carb, doesn't work, we get the cravings, we've got to fight willpower. Then we go high protein. Protein is acid forming. So the more protein we have, the more acid we have, the more acid we have, the more the body needs to alkaline it. And one of the ways it alkalines the blood is with calcium. So because calcium's an alkaline mineral, so it takes calcium out of the bones, dumps it in the blood to try and alkalize it, so the homeostasis of the human body runs normally. Where does it get the calcium from? Our bones. That's why those in Western society have a high acid diet. We have high rates of osteoporosis. Then we get these TV bloody commercials that we think are nutritional information and they are an ad. And the TV commercial says, drink more milk. Where does the cow get its calcium?
Grass.
Green leafy vegetables. Where does an elephant get its calcium? Green leafy vegetables. We drink milk from a cow, and a cow doesn't even drink the milk, and the milk's been pasteurised, homogenised, messed up, and we think that that is going to solve our problem. And yet the highest rates of osteoporosis in the world are in dairy-drinking countries. If you want milk, get a cow, where it's raw, or breastfeed. That's what we're supposed to do now, politically correct shit, you're not allowed to hang them out anymore. Not allowed to hang them out. Next thing, we'll see gorillas in the zoo, got a little thing over there, can't watch them, gorillas feeding. We did. We just fed. We just hung them out, very normal, not allowed to do that. So what happened is we've got the low carb, that's a problem. Doesn't work, because you go on and off and on and off and on and off a diet. We have high protein, acid, worse condition, everything all hurts. Do you know what we haven't tried? High fat. What they do is they say go low fat. If you eat a high fat, good fat we're talking about, okay, good fat.
Nuts.
Good fat. Okay? If we eat a high fat diet, we teach the body to burn fat as fuel. So then you're eating nuts and seeds and you're getting all these fats, and when you think you want to lose a bit of fat, you slow down a little bit and the body's going, where's the fat? Ooh, there's a bit. So it's going to eat your own fat. It can't eat your own sugars, because if you cut down, you only store a little bit of sugar and you're going to get lethargic. And you're going to get cravings because your body's going, we want something to eat. Whereas if you teach it to burn fat, it's going to find fat on you. If you teach to eat protein, in the end, if you don't give it the protein, it's going to eat your protein, which is your muscle. And you're going to go, oh, I ache, I'm sore, I feel like I'm getting the flu. Eat fat. We never had kids with peanut allergies once before. We never had any kids with allergies now. They've got everything. Might this be the chemicals and the preservatives that have changed the biochemistry of the human body? The solution is, the biggest problem isn't that 80% of diseases or 8 out of 10 people are feeding themselves their own disease. The problem is parent error. We are the teachers of our children, yet we are handing them over to a disease management system that doesn't give a shit about our kids' health. So the only way is to step up and say, we as parents are not going to rely on health departments, we are going to take it on board ourselves, to the point that the health department has to listen. Because we as parents are going to preserve our kids' health by giving them this. Now, the Dietetics Association is flawed too. When we start to do this, I would love to do a demonstration where I could take what's on that table and turn it into something that will blow your tits off. Balls off, you guys. I'm talking about getting dried fruits and nuts and making a pie base instead of flour, water, sugar, butter, all that sort of thing. I'm talking about getting cashew nuts and soaking them in coconut water, pureeing them with mangoes and things like that, and making a banana cream pie or a mango cream pie. You've tasted some of the stuff that I've done.
Oh, yeah.
The difference in our children, the difference in the behaviour to our children. So we've got one thing. One is behaviour. The other one is to keep them out of the hospital. It is cheaper to feed your kid well in the long run. Would you go and put no-name fuel in your car? No. Because you know that it would damage your car. And yet we would do it to ourselves. So it's up to us to say, right, we're going to take this to the next level and the next level and the next level, to the point that this is what is being delivered and packaged and sent into schools. We don't want Coke in schools. We don't want white bread in schools. We don't want any of that, because if the kids eat that, the change will be phenomenal. They have, and I don't want to go into the hidden agenda, but they don't have our interest at heart. Nursing home, old and dying patients, and the doctor's doing his rounds, and he comes in, and this person says, doctor, you don't understand. I'm not crying because I'm dying. I'm crying because I've never lived. A little bit later, after the doctor's left the room, the woman's dream walks in, and the woman bows her head in shame, and the dream said, why didn't you use me? And said, I always thought there was tomorrow. And the dream said, we only ever have the moment of now. Everything starts in the moment of now. So why didn't you use me? The woman said, I didn't think I could. And the dream said, you fool. The dream's the template for your life. All you ever had to do was believe. We're there for you the whole way. And with that, the woman died, and so did her dream. Don't let it be us. If someone doesn't make a stand, nothing will get changed. So it's up to us to spread the word, to say we want to change, we want to get out of the system, and we want to prevent health in our children. I collect old medical dictionaries. One in 1938, there's three cancers, three pages on cancer. Now there's 18 thousand. We have created our own disease through knife, food, and ignorance.
So could I just bring up this before, just so I don't forget. The autism rate has gone from 1 in 10,000 to 1 in 100. Now, I'll give you a couple of reasons why, but what not now, but there is a couple of reasons why, and it's not just vaccines, there's other factors as well, right? At the end of the day, we've got schools that have got a disabled child to some degree in every classroom now. Now, autism's meant to go to 1 in 10. There's nothing going to stop it from 1 in 100 going down to 1 in 10. Was it magically just going to stop at 1 in 100? No, it's not. So I've got a big problem that we're going to need more special schools than you can poke a stick at. We need to do something, and I am taking that stand. I'm copping it too. By the way, I've copped my fluoride stance. Remember, fluoride, they use to make an overactive thyroid normal. What are we doing with a normal thyroid if we're using fluoride? It's a no-brainer, and it's a neurotoxin. The blood goes to the brain. What you put in your blood goes to your brain.
We don't need takeaways either. And I always, you know, my husband and I always have sort of a bit of a joke. We go home and say, fast food tonight. It's a piece of steak on the grill and some tomato and, you know, veggies. And, you know, it takes about 15 minutes to do that food, and I would wait longer in a takeaway food place to buy that.
To poison yourself.
And poison myself. Yeah. But it comes down to just making the time once a week to plan. It's all about planning. And I think it's the old saying, if you don't plan, you plan to fail.
Thank you.
On behalf of P&C's Queensland, Jason, thank you very much for attending today and giving us a different perspective on foods that we could take away. And Samantha,
thank you.
Thank you so much.